And welcome to LPEP, the show where comedians and musicians face off with some music trivia, a brand new concept that in no way has ever been covered before on Australian television. But first, would you please welcome our team captains, Adam Knox and Beck Russo? Adam's first guest tonight is a comedian from Brisbane. He's had to change some of his jokes for a Melbourne audience now that he's moved here. Namely, that all of his punchlines are, "And then I got a latte." It's Greg Larsen! Adam's second guest tonight performed a show in the recent comedy festival that focused on a disgraced footballer. Oh, no, no, please, please, leave your televisions on. I promise you it's not Ricky Nixon. Thankfully, it's Tegan Higginbotham. Beck's first guest has a track from his most recent EP with several possible names. From Isles, it's Simon Adam Lamb, or Simon Danger Lamb, or Simon Wold Black Betty Bamba Lamb. It's Simon Lamb! Beck's second guest tonight is the brother of Simon Lamb and also the brother of Eliza Lamb from Oh Mercy, which really proves one thing, that the Lamb family needed more goddamn rules in their household. From Brightley, it's Nick Lamb! Our first round tonight is hits and giggles. Each team will watch two artists' music videos and then pick one of the artists as the answer to my question. Beck, Simon, Nick, let's take a look at yours. That was John Butler Trio with Zebra and Chet Faker with No Diggity, but which one of these two artists had their song stolen for a yogurt ad featuring in a Super Bowl?
Ooh, okay. In a Super Bowl.
You guys big fans of NFL? No. Good question to start off with, I guess.
No.
Stolen's a strong word.
It is. Well, it was.
What do you mean? Well, it was stolen.
That's
obviously,
the word that we're using.
Obviously, they used it without his permission or whoever's permission. Yeah, I guess
they didn't break into his house and steal his copy of the CD.
Maybe they did.
Rub a nail on the cover, guys. I think for Super Bowl, it's got to be quite upbeat, and the John Butler Trio, they just seem a bit more boppity, you know what
just,
I mean?
Just yogurt, you're helping them
they're
out.
Different.
I will say this.
Thanks, Tegan.
The other one.
Both of those songs have been used in Super Bowls. Okay. Only one of them was stolen.
Okay.
So,
what do you think? Do you think John Butler likes yogurt?
Yeah, he's a yogurt guy.
Well, he wasn't asked permission, so it doesn't matter
true.
Whether he likes yogurt or not.
What do you think?
It's John.
John Butler? Let's go with John Butler.
You reckon it's John Butler?
Yep.
You're right. It was John Butler that had his song Zebra stolen in the 2012 NFL Super Bowl. Adam, Tegan, Greg, let's take a look at yours. That was Gautier with Easy Way Out and Sia with Clap Your Hands. But which one of these two artists was nominated for a Silver Glove Award at the One Band International Festival of Puppetry in 2009?
Oh. Yeah, One Band, yeah.
It's a famous festival. It's a super. Yeah.
Okay, so is that saying that there was puppetry in the clip or that they were the puppeteers?
They do puppeteering. As I think it's called, puppeteering outside of their musical activities. The reason why it's called One Van International Festival of Puppetry is because all of the puppeteers just drive up in vans, like really old combi vans. And so they're like, oh yeah, we'll just call it the One Van.
That'd be like 50 vans, though.
Exactly.
Yeah, that's it's a little bit confused.
How many puppeteers are there? Like, there's got to be like three?
Like, well, yeah.
There's actually just one, yeah. But he has all the others on strings as well. It's just like a pyramid.
I mean, to see a film clip, you'd think it was her, but that sounds like such a GTA thing to do.
Trick question, yeah. Because he would be, he's the kind of guy that would be mucking around with puppets, surely.
Yeah, and she's like, this one's really sad.
You've clearly seen evidence that Sia does muck around with puppets.
Yeah, she totally does. But
that's what I'm saying. It's a trick because we've seen puppets. It's like, oh, we'll go with the puppet one, but no.
And in the film clip,
I love it how they're doing psychological tricks.
But in the Sia film clip as well, I don't think she could have been doing those puppets in her film clip. She had Gautier doing those puppets in her film clip.
Yeah.
It's all coming together.
That makes sense. That actually does.
Sia naturally kind of looks like a puppet a bit with her haircut as well. Do you know what I mean? She has like that puppet haircut.
More like that Muppet sort of like.
Yeah.
She looks like a puppet when she's in the puppet.
In the puppet suit.
In the puppet suit. Yeah. Like, it looks quite puppety.
I'm going to go
Gautier.
Probably
a real puppet. That was a real puppet.
You think
sure.
It's Gautier?
I reckon it's a Gautier kind of thing. And he could. He'd be like, well, this one's sad, this one's happy. And
yeah.
Yeah. You don't know, man. You should know.
This was in 2009.
Yeah.
Which really doesn't have any bearing on the answer at all, but I just wanted to point out.
2009. It was a great puppet year.
I just reckon, I'm going to go Gautier.
All right.
Definitely.
That's cool. I agree. Yeah, I
all think right. Gautier. We'll go Gautier.
Democratically elected.
Yeah. We're on the blue team, so.
You're right. It was Gautier. It was nominated for the Silver Glove Award at the International Festival of Puppetry in 2009. Our next round is Bangers and Mash. Each team will listen to some mashups, guess the titles of the songs in that mashup, and then, with those titles in mind, come up with their own name. Adam, Tegan, Greg, let's listen to yours.
I am an arms dealer, fitting you with weapons in the form of
first mashup, Adam, Tegan, and Greg. What were the two songs in that mashup?
So we've got Jets, Are You Gonna Be My Girl?
Yes.
And then we can't think of the other one.
We know it's called like
This ain't a scene, it's a goddamn something.
Yeah, that's the name of the song.
This ain't a scene?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's a goddamn.
We don't know the name of the song.
But
are you gonna give me wait. Yeah. That's the partial title. I'm gonna throw it to Beck, Nick and Simon, who might have the full title.
This ain't a scene, it's an arms race by Fall Out Boy.
Fall Out Boy. Very, very well done. Adam, Tegan, Greg, what did you come up with? What were the titles you had?
So the one I like best is This Ain't My Girl, but it has to be with a question mark at the end. Like, it really is like, oh my God, this ain't my girl. This is weird.
You've been out partying, you wake up, turn over.
Yeah.
This ain't my girl.
This ain't my girl.
This ain't my girl.
I think Shaggy would sing that one. Any other ones?
Fall Out of a Jet is...
That's pretty...
It's more of a...
Yeah.
It's more of a headline than a... Or like a...
Yeah, that's definitely a new headline.
Boy falls out of a jet. Jet a bad? We can call it that.
That's quite good.
Fall Out of a Jet, I'm giving that a point straight away.
There we go.
You guys got 2 points because you got
Let's put a question mark at the end of that one as well.
Mashup, did you guys have any
titles? I had exactly Fall Out of a Jet. I wrote it down. Yeah. So
I'm not going to give you any points.
We had another one. Simon came up with Are You Gonna Be My Boy?
Ah, it's 2013, let's go.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Come on.
I'm going to give that a point as well. Very, very well done. Simon, Nick, Beck, we've got a mashup for you. Let's have a listen. Mashup, Beck, Simon,
We had
Nick.
Praise You by Fatboy Slim.
Absolutely.
And I Don't Care by Icona Pop.
Icona Pop, Who does Icona Pop feature?
Featuring Charlie XCX.
Very well done, 100%. Ooh, what was the title that you gave to that mashup?
Wow.
We've got a couple.
Yeah, that's good. The more the better.
Simon had Fat Boy Don't Care.
Yeah, I'm a fat boy and I don't care.
I have no problem with the fact that a lot of people worship Buddha.
Okay.
What?
That's more of a commentary. I have no problem with Buddha. Buddha. Where did the Buddha come into it?
I don't care. Praise you, fat boy.
Right. Wow, that's like levels of sophistication above everything else.
Right,
I'm giving that a point purely because that was intelligent. All right. Any other ones? No, that's pretty much it. Two. All right. Get 3 points for that. Did you guys come up with any?
We did, actually. And just on that, these mashups are awesome. You've got to sell these mashups.
They're not mine, so I can't do that.
Oh, boom. They're pretty good mashups.
I've stolen them off the internet.
Really?
For use in the Super Bowl.
For use in the Super Bowl.
So we had I Don't Praise You, and then in brackets we had Liberal Party, which we're filming this before the election, guys, so that's cutting.
Yeah. We don't know whether we're having a go at the current government or not.
Yeah.
I've got one more.
Oh, excellent, yes.
Which is I Don't Do Fat Boys, which 100%. I'm just going to say is just a title because, frankly, I'm single and I can't have rules. So just putting that out there.
At the end of that round, we have both teams on 4 points. Very, very close. Very well done, guys. Our next round is the Twinsy round, where each team will be predicting their teammates' answers to my question. Tegan, you'll be predicting what Greg says, and Nick, you'll be predicting what Simon says. First question for Simon and Greg. Who is taller? So you and Tegan, and who's taller out of you and Nick?
Just an easy
one. It should be fairly simple. So who's taller? Hopefully you've written something.
Yep.
Greg, who is taller out of you and Tegan?
Big Greg.
Big Greg. And Tegan, what did you put down?
Personality, because I think it's like who's the bigger person? It'd be me, yeah.
That's
but
amazing.
Big Greg, see? There we go. Hold on. So still right. There we go.
The person is a point for Greg and Tegan. Simon, who is taller out of you and Nick?
Nick's definitely taller.
Nick?
Yeah.
And Nick, what did you say?
I said, yes, me. And I drew a picture of me.
There we go. Very well done. That is a point. Who do you think your teammate's favourite Australian artist or band is? Favourite Australian artist or band. So, Tegan, what do you think Greg's favourite Australian artist or band is?
And
Nick, what do you think Simon's favourite Australian artist or band is? I'm going to press you for an answer. Simon, who's your favourite Australian artist or band?
Slow Dancer.
Slow Dancer. And Nick, what did
you
have down?
They're a good band, but I'll tell everyone that it's definitely Flume.
Greg, who is your favourite Australian artist or band?
There's a lot to choose from, but I think I will have to say Silverchair.
Oh! Oh!
Point to Adam's team.
And I just figured that if you don't know somebody and you have to pick your favourite Australian band, just go with Silverchair because they're awesome.
Exactly. Silverchair or Powderfinger.
Yeah.
You're a freak.
What is your teammate's best feature?
Oh, I don't have any. I don't have any good features.
It doesn't have to be physical. Oh. It can be sociological.
Might be your adamant stance that you are going to one day sleep with Kesha.
That's true.
Best feature. All right, I'm going to push you for an answer. Simon, what is your best feature?
I think I've got a pretty good ability to finish everyone's leftovers at dinner.
That's not a bad one.
Mm.
That's not a bad one at all.
Very,
is that useful?
Very food-focused, man.
Yeah. Well, I just love it.
They're getting very excited.
They're talking my language.
is this a good feature for him to have? Nick, you guys live together.
Yeah, it's a good feature. I actually would. It's food-related, definitely. I thought it would have been his ability to cook a Maggi noodle stir fry.
Not bad.
Greg, what is your best feature?
I have opposable thumbs, which I guess everyone has.
That's true.
That's quite good.
Like, in terms of
evolution. I can grip anything I want.
I'm just going to say I haven't got grip, okay?
Okay. Like, if I'm being honest, video games, I'm so good at them.
Really?
Yeah, I'm so good at video games.
Anyone in particular? Just for the crowd that's watching.
This is just going to get so nerdy, like Empire Total War, which is the sequel to Medieval 2 Total War. I'm pretty good at it.
It's a great game.
Call of Duty.
Sure.
Play that a bit, shoot them up. Go on, have a crack.
All right, Tegan, what did you have? Was it Call of Duty?
Look, it wasn't Call of Duty or Grip. Look, first of all, it was your crazy self-esteem because your first reaction was, I've got nothing good about myself.
That's true. I'm very, very depressed.
But no, I disagree. I reckon you rock the colour black, so I wrote that. And you're really good at standing up for the underdog. And in Kesha's case, I really emphasised the dog bit.
That time someone gave it to Kesha.
Our very, very last question. Which celebrity is your one free pass? Which celebrity is your one free pass? Pardon? Greg, who is your one celebrity free pass?
Up until 2010, it would have been Björk. Like, Björk is just the most wonderful person in the entire world, except for Kesha. She is the most beautiful, wonderful person in the world. And when that song TikTok came out, Kesha, which camera am I looking at? Kesha, if you're watching this, I love you so much.
Yeah, I've not come close then in that case.
What did you have?
Well, you see, I didn't have an idea, so I just had to go for mine, which is Emma Watson or Monica Bellucci.
Monica Bellucci.
And I was just hoping that we had similar lady crushes, but obviously we fucking don't.
All right, so no points for that one.
Oh, and I'm also going to change my name to Greg with the Euro sign as the E.
Yeah, nice.
And that's so good. That's so good.
Oh, you're so international. Simon, who is your one celebrity free pass?
I don't think he's a celebrity as high caliber as those people, but in my eyes, he's above them, far beyond. I'd have to take Huey from Huey's Cooking Adventures.
Yeah.
Is there any particular reason?
Oh, he's just got great recipes.
Oh, and Nick, what did you have down?
Well, I honestly thought that because sometimes Simon's got like a bit of a wavy hair thing going on, and that if he rocked up to a party with Michael Loonig, he'd kind of look in place because he kind of looks like a Loonig character to me sometimes. So if he's walking around with Michael, I reckon that'd be...
It'd just be a very poignant lovemaking section.
So, after that round, we have Beck's team on 9 points and Adam's team just ahead on 10 points.
It's a good number. Yeah. I like how many points that is.
Yeah. Points are great.
Our last round is called the budget round because we spent our money on everything else. Each team will have to give me the next line of lyrics from the lyrics I will give them. Adam, Tegan, Greg, you're up first. Here we go. Black fingernails.
Red wine.
Black fingernails, red wine, Eskimo Joe.
Barbara Streisand.
Barbara Streisand, duck sauce.
Nice.
All you do is smother me, hug and hide and cover me, you're...
Great, so good.
Is swab it over, any ideas? Bad to me. Rocket to the break of day. That's a song, I need the lyric.
Go to the break of day.
Turn the thing at top of day.
Is that English? No. I'm going to throw it over.
Don't stop rocking. Don't stop rocking now. Little red.
No way. Don't stop rocking now. No way. Rock it, little red. If your dad doesn't have a beard.
You've got two mums.
If your dad doesn't have a beard, you got two mums. I could be standing on the shadow of your ghost. I could be standing on the shadow of your ghost.
But I'm like metal because that's physically impossible. Ghosts don't have shadows or exist.
I'm going to swap it over.
I could be standing on the shadow of your ghost.
I could be standing on the shadow of your ghost. I could be standing on the shadow of your ghost. You wouldn't tell me, and I think that hurts the most. Good news, Philadelphia grand jury. I saw a UFO, but nobody believes me.
I saw a UFO, but nobody believes me.
Something, the USA?
Oh, I'm going to swap it over.
16 miles from home, but nobody inside.
I said, 16 miles from home, nobody inside. UFO sneaky sound system. I'd rather do it with Madonna.
Than with
I'd rather
Bill.
Do it with Madonna. She's what a woman's supposed to be.
Android. Very well done. All right, Beck, Nick, Simon, you need 3 points to draw, 4 points to win. Your time starts now. Maybe I'm a desperate believer. Gonna pass it over.
Walking in a straight line.
Walking in a straight line.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, no, because I didn't listen to that last album because it sucked a bit.
You blocked me on Facebook.
Something about internet friends. Oh, I know the song. You blocked
me. And now you're gonna die.
And now you're gonna die. Or we'll need the tungsten light. We'll need the tungsten light. It's an Isle song.
So you... I've been outright.
Took a little too long there. That girl's a genius. She's a genius. Jet, maybe I should go out and try something that really, really scares me. Perhaps you would know this, Nick, being a Brightly song. Maybe I should go out and try something that really, really scares me.
Line.
No, I need the next line. Oh. I'm gonna pop it over if you've got any idea.
Like a scary man from the show.
Maybe I should just admit that I will never be that good at
contact sports. Like I was saying, Bradley. Sport or music.
You did say it before, but you didn't get the line. Such a hard act to follow.
Such a hard act to follow. Such a fine looking fellow.
Such a fine looking fellow. Hard act to follow. Grinspoon. It was dark in the car park. I heard a lark ascending.
And you laughed.
And you laughed. Pre-flight nerves, Brightly. You saved yourself there. Yeah. I'm loving what you do to me. You're not like any other.
Something underneath the cover.
Yeah, it's the sweetest kiss I've ever known underneath the covers. Yep. Roll disco, vaudeville smash. I will ignore. I will compete. I'll turn your ship into a fleet. If Eliza would hear, she would get it.
Oh, is it a messy?
Pass it over. Any idea, guys?
Say it again.
I will ignore. I will compete. I'll turn your ship into a fleet.
I'm a shipbuilder.
To make you understand really that you are my man. My man. Mercy.
Oh, sorry, Lars.
And at the end of that round, I had Simon, Nick and Beck on 18 points, only to be trumped by Adam, Tegan and Greg on 19 points. Very well done. Tonight's winners.
Come on,
again to all of the guests on tonight's show, Nick Lamb, Simon Lamb, Tegan Higginbotham, and Greg Larsen. Thank you so much, guys.
No problem.
We'll be back next week with another show. Until then, I've been Mike O'Donoghue. You've been wonderful. See you then.